Basically, there are three grades. You can see that normal grade is 36 to 37 degrees Celsius, I have done, and mild is between 37 to 38 degrees Celsius, and above 30, if something is 38 degrees Celsius, then it is dead, means danger zone. So this is automatic operation. So as soon as my temperature will be measured, so that temperature will be shown on the LCD as well, and that temperature will shown on the mobile phone as well, wirelessly, right? So over here, directly on the LCD, the temperature will be shown, and over here on mobile phone, wirelessly, the temperature will be shown. And now, after measuring the temperature, a person will come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then you can see that barrier will open automatically. If person is standing over here in front of this ultrasonic sensor, you can see that the barrier will open. Automatically, it will go down. The temperature is coming in red. Why? Because temperature is very high. Now if I will come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then nothing is happening. Why? Because the temperature is very high, above 38 degrees Celsius. That's why nothing is happening.
Take.
Hello friends, I hope all are doing great. So let me explain you before starting the actual working of the project. Something about the project, what's going on. So this is the version first of the same project. Version first is just temperature measurement on Android phone and on LCD as well. So this is in version 1 and version 2, but in today's project, which is version 3, so we are going to control a barrier as well, which you can say Fatak in local language. We are going to control a barrier as well, which will on only if the temperature is under range. If temperature is above range, if temperature is abnormal, then the Fatak or the barrier or the gate is not going to open. So this is latest project on COVID. So this project can be implemented in public places or in hospital or where you need security. Automatically, the temperature of the person will be measured and the gate will only open if temperature of the person is under range. If the temperature is above, then the barrier is not going to open. So we are using a lots of component in this project. I'm going to explain you one by one. So version 1, you can see on my channel Circuits Bazaar, you can see version 1 and version 2. Then you can come to version 3. Let me explain you the circuit. So basically this is the photo of the project. So let me tell you what type of component we are using. So we are using Bluetooth module. If I can increase the size, then I can show you. So this is the Bluetooth module and this is the MLX90614 temperature sensor. This is your Arduino board. This is your 7805 voltage regulator, because through this 7805 voltage regulator, we are providing separate power supply to the servo motor. So this is the high torque servo motor, which will control this barrier. So this is the barrier, this black color barrier we are controlling, right? This is your LCD. On LCD, we are displaying the temperature of the person. So the benefit of LCD is as soon as the temperature will be measured of the person, so that person also can see what is the temperature of his body, and the temperature will be wirelessly sent to the mobile phone as well, on the Android mobile phone. So this is the barrier. So this barrier will open and close only if the temperature is under range. The temperature will be measured by this MLX90614 temperature sensor, which is wireless IR temperature sensor. So this is the ultrasonic sensor. This ultrasonic sensor will detect the person. So as soon as the ultrasonic will detect the person, so it will ask the permission from the Arduino. So Arduino will give the permission only if temperature is under range. If temperature is not under range, then in that case, it won't allow the servo motor to open the barrier. So this is the simple working of this project. So power supply we are taking through this 12 volt adapter. So this 12 volt adapter is taking power supply from 230 volt AC and converting that into high current 12 volt DC. So this 12 volt DC is running the complete project. So let me share you some code tips. The code you can find from the description given below. So this is the code. The code is same as version 1 and version 2. So we have added only two components here. One is ultrasonic sensor we have added, and another we have added the servo motor. Servo motor to control the barrier and ultrasonic to detect the person so that it can give the signal to the controller so that it can open the Fatak or the barrier. So now if I talk about the code, so this is the code. So this is the servo library we have included. This is the servo library, and if I talk about other things are same, you just need to go through version 1 and version 2, which is the earlier video, right? Only the extra thing I'm going to explain in this code. So this is the servo library you have included, and these are the ultrasonic pin. So pin number 7 and pin number 8 we are using as a trig pin or eco pin of the ultrasonic sensor. Now if I'll go below, then you can see that servo motor I have connected on pin number 9. And then we have written 0, like the servo direction we have given 0. So it can rotate from 0 degree to 180 degree. Servo motor can rotate from 0 degree to 180 degree. Now let me come down and I'll tell you how the ultrasonic is working. So here the servo we have initialized. Now ultrasonic, for the ultrasonic, we just need to trigger. You must go through the interfacing of ultrasonic sensor through Arduino. If you don't know, it's very simple. You just need to send the pulse and you just need to measure the time that pulse is taking to come back. So this is the pulse we have provided, and then we are measuring the distance. Distance we have measured in inches over here. So you can see that. Then we are comparing. We have actually measured, did the calculations in inches and centimeter both. So now you can see that we are testing over here two conditions. The distance must be of that person must be between 1 to 6 inches, right? And the temperature must be below 40 degree. So these are the two conditions. So as you know that we are using over here AND operator. So both of these two conditions must be true. The first condition and the second condition, both of these conditions must be true. Only then it will allow the FATAC to open. So to open the gate or the barrier, this will give a 95 degree. So 95 is the angle we have given to the servo motor so that it can open the barrier, right? If this condition is not match, then there is a else condition. So in else condition, what we have done, we have given servo motor only 0, nothing else. So this is all about the code. So only the extra thing we have done in this code in comparison to version 1 and version 2 is that we are just using ultrasonic sensor over here or servo motor, nothing else. All the code is same. So I'm going to attach this code in the description given below, so you can download from there. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. And if you like the video, you can subscribe the channel, or you can like the video. So let me now explain the practical working of the project. We are going to study the advanced COVID project. So in this project we are using multiple feature. The number one feature is this project will measure the temperature wirelessly and display on the Android phone the temperature reading, as well as it will display temperature reading on the LCD. If everything is okay, then only it will allow the person to pass through this gate. So this is the barrier. This barrier will open only if the temperature behind is okay. If temperature is not correct, then it won't open this barrier. So if I talk about what is the temperature okay range, I'm going to show you on the app. So the app we are going to use is wireless temperature measurement app. I'm going to show you. First of all, let me just tell you about the project. So this is the temperature sensor MLX90614. So this temperature sensor will measure the reading wirelessly. Right, this temperature sensor will measure the reading wirelessly. Means there is no need to touch the body. It will automatically measure the reading from your body and will give that data to the Arduino board. Then Arduino board through Bluetooth module will give data to the mobile phone. So this is the Bluetooth module. So right now you can see that this LED is flashing very fast. You know why? Because Bluetooth module is not connected to the mobile phone. As soon as this Bluetooth mobile will be connected to the mobile phone, then this LED will start blinking slowly. This is the LCD. Right now you can see that the temperature reading on the LCD is 18.9 degrees Celsius. So this is the temperature. You can say this is the room temperature. Now let me show you. As soon as I'll keep my hand in front of this sensor, now you can see temperature changes. So this is 27 degrees Celsius. So this is the temperature reading of my hand right now. So this reading is measured by this temperature sensor wirelessly, right? You can fit this temperature sensor on some object. once the temperature is okay, means the okay temperature is below 40 degrees Celsius. So when temperature is okay, then if the person will come, so this ultrasonic sensor will sense the body of the person and will automatically open the barrier if temperature is below 40 degrees Celsius. If temperature is above 40 degrees Celsius, then it's not going to open this barrier. If I talk about this LCD, the temperature reading is coming to the security guard on his mobile phone as well as this reading is coming on the LCD as well. So this LCD you can place in front of the sensor or near to the sensor, MLX90614, so that the user, or you can say the person, can see the reading of his body. So what is the reading of his body? Right now, if I talk about in the market, if you are entering into a hotel, so that security guard measure your temperature reading, but you don't know the temperature reading, what is your temperature, that temperature reading is shown to the security guard, not you. But over here, through this project, the reading will go to the security guard as well on his mobile phone and as well as on the LCD. So this LCD size also you can increase. So now the benefit is customer, or you can say the person, will also see the temperature reading of his body. So right now you can see that temperature is 19.2 degrees Celsius. This is the temperature, something variable temperature right now. Now let me connect it to the mobile phone. So this is the mobile phone. If you will go on Play Store, then you will find a app. The app name is Wireless IR Temperature Scanner. So this is the app. Now I'm going to connect. Then I'll go to this SC05 module. Over here you will find something like this number, let me first connect it to the through the Bluetooth setting. First you will go to the Bluetooth setting. Only once you will need to do this thing, just off it, and I'm going to again on it. Now it is going to search the Bluetooth module. So now click over here, so you will find this SC05. This is the Bluetooth module, SC05. Just click on it. It will ask for the password. So the password you need to enter is 1234. 1234. Click OK. Now this Bluetooth module is connected. Let me go to the app. So this is the app. So in the app, let me tell you from the very starting. As soon as you will click on the app, it will give you option. Click on connect. Click on this SC05, SC06. Now go to this connect option above. Click on this connect. And this is SC05. You can see that SC05. This is the Bluetooth module. This is the Bluetooth module. Now you can see that Bluetooth module is blinking very, very slowly. You know why? Because this Bluetooth module is connected now. Now you can see that the temperature reading is also on the mobile phone, 18.65 degrees Celsius. So this is the temperature reading right now. Okay. The same reading over here and the same reading on the LCD as well. So this operation is wirelessly. Now you can see that the temperature reading on the mobile phone. These are the reading in the environment. Okay, so it is showing room temperature and this temperature. So basically there are three grade. You can see that normal grade is 36 to 37 degrees Celsius I have done, and mild is between 37 to 38 degrees Celsius, and above 30, if something is 38 degrees Celsius, then it is red, means danger zone, right? So if I talk about this ultrasonic sensor and barrier combination, I have set at 40 degrees Celsius. If temperature is above 40 degrees Celsius, or you can say 38 degrees Celsius, then this barrier won't open, even if the person is over here, means even if the ultrasonic sensor will sense. Now let me show you the experiment. इसको बड़ा कर दीजिए, बड़ा 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 बड़ा, ऐसे 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 ऐसे
वो स्क्रिप्ट है।
हाँ, ना ना पोज करने की जरूरत नहीं, वो मैं काट दूंगा,
स्टार्टिंग कर दूंगा।
So now let me show you how it's working. So right now temperature is 18.2 degrees Celsius. So this is the hot gun. I'm going to increase the temperature around the sensor. Now you can see that. Now you can see that the temperature is very high, 95 degrees Celsius something. Okay, so if something will come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then nothing is happening. Why? Because temperature is very high. You can see on the LCD, temperature is very high, 77-88 degrees Celsius. Now, if I'm coming in front of this ultrasonic sensor, you can see that nothing is happening, right? Nothing is happening. But if the temperature will be normal in front of that IR sensor, now you can see the temperature is 18 degrees something, 18 degrees Celsius. This is the temperature, okay? Now, if I'll come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, you will see the barrier will open, right? Then automatically it will go down. As soon as I'll come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, the barrier will open. So first the temperature will be measured. Now, let's say for example, my temperature is 24 degrees Celsius, and then I'll come in front of this ultrasonic sensor. So barrier will open so that I can pass if there is something, say, some area like, let's say, court or some other public place, or you can say airport. So this is automatic operation. So as soon as my temperature will be measured, so that temperature will be shown on the LCD as well, and that temperature will be shown on the mobile phone as well, wirelessly, right? So over here, directly on the LCD, the temperature will be shown, and over here on mobile phone, wirelessly, the temperature will be shown. And now, after measuring the temperature, a person will come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then you can see that barrier will open automatically. If person is standing over here in front of this ultrasonic sensor, you can see that the barrier will open. Automatically, it will go down. Let me show you through this again. This is the hot gun. You can see the temperature is very high. Just see the temperature on the screen. You can see the temperature is above 80 degrees Celsius. Now, over here as well, you can see red. The temperature is coming in red. Why? Because temperature is very high. Now, if I'll come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then nothing is happening. Why? Because the temperature is very high, above 38 degrees Celsius. That's why nothing is happening. Now, as soon as the temperature, now you can see that I was in front of this ultrasonic sensor, so you have to be careful while showing the operation. So now you can see that my body temperature is low now, 24 degrees Celsius. After this, if I'll come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then immediately the FATAC will open. Okay, then it will go down automatically. Temperature is 18 degrees Celsius environment. Now my temperature is 24.5 degrees Celsius. You can see the temperature over here as well. So this is green, in green. Why? Because temperature is in the normal range. Now if I'll come in front of this ultrasonic sensor, then FATAC will open automatically. So this is advanced COVID project. So this is all about this project. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like it, you can subscribe the channel, or if you have any doubt, then you can ask me in the comment section. I hope I have explained everything. Let me explain you again. This is servo motor. Servo motor is basically very if you want to move something on a particular angle, then servo motor is the best thing. This is of high torque servo motor, right? This is ultrasonic sensor. This is LCD. You can increase size a little bit. This is servo motor, this is ultrasonic sensor, this is LCD, this is 7805 to provide separate power to the servo motor, this is Arduino board, this is potentiometer to set the contrast of the LCD, this one, okay, ultrasonic sensor sensed me. This is MLX90614 wireless temperature sensor, and this is a Bluetooth module. This is your Bluetooth module, and this is your power adapter. We are using 12 volt power adapter to run the power supply. So this is all about this project, and this is your Android phone, as you know that. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.